So, what is up? I'm J-Mart, here with my buddy Josh, and we're a couple of real geniuses, right? That's the name of this episode. That's the name of every episode, because that's the name of the show. Anywho, this is a new podcast with my buddy Josh we'll be doing for a while, hopefully. I mean, I kind of think it's going to be for a while. What do you think, Josh? Think it's going to be for a while?
Absolutely.
Who knows? Who knows? It could be done tomorrow. We'll see how this goes. But like I said, we're a couple before we ever get started. We're trying to make this happen. We're going with it. But this may be the final episode if it is. We had a good run. You know. I enjoyed the intro at least. You know, we had some good times. We had some okay times. There was the best of times, it was the worst of times. Grapes of Wrath right?
Yeah.
I don't know. Now, if you look at the logo, you'll be like, well, God, geniuses would at least know how to spell real and geniuses. Touche. It might be spelled R-E-E-L. But that's because we're not really geniuses. And geniuses might be misspelled as well. But like I said, we're not really geniuses. No. Nay, nay. We just know a lot about movies and video games and some other niche things. So, I mean, in that context, we are real geniuses of, like, movie reels. It's a play on words, people. Semantics, right? Like, don't get it twisted.
More or less self-proclaimed.
Yeah, we're not that smart. If you ever think that you're the dumbest person in the world, watch one of these videos. Watch one of these episodes and realize...
Very uplifting.
You're not. There are at least two people in this world dumber than you at any given moment. And it's probably us.
Yeah.
But enough about us.
Exactly.
Let's talk about what we are playing today if you're watching this on YouTube, which is Rocket League. We're playing the Rumble mode. It's fun. It's a blast. Go ahead and check it out if you're watching this on YouTube. You know, it's probably going to be a lot of us losing because neither of us are really focusing on the game right now, I don't think. So
Speak for yourself. I'm in tryhard mode like no other.
It'll be a fun experience. Don't expect a lot of victories while we're doing this. But yeah, check out Rocket League. Great game out by Psyonix. Super fun. Super clean game. It's polished very well. And one of my favorite games of the year. But enough about that. Let's get back to the real nitty gritty. What do you think we are going to talk about this week, Josh? Because we didn't discuss that beforehand. We didn't make a
plan. No, we did not. I mean, the possibilities are limitless, given the time frame. I mean, it's Christmas season. It's, you know, the crazies are out doing the hustle and bustle of trying to get a gift and running people over.
Yeah.
Tensions flying.
Tensions are
what,
flying.
Did I get the proper gift? Did I not? And then trying to balance in, you know, the routine of what we try to do on a day-to-day basis.
The apocalypse is on the brink.
Yes.
We have some great movies coming out.
We do.
Great video games. You know, literally endless possibilities. We also could just, you know, BS it. We could just ramble on and on. And I feel like that probably wouldn't be the best way to fill a 30-minute to an hour-long void. But
no.
I have watched plenty of TV shows that would beg to differ. So
Seinfeld.
I think... Yes, exactly. You know, I think we'll make it just fine rambling. We could just Valley Girl it and have fun, you know.
Like totally
have a lot of fun. Anywho, you talked about bringing up family with Christmas. I am lucky, unlike you, to not have a children and or wife to impress this season. All I have to do is buy stuff for myself.
I don't feel unlucky in that. I mean, it's very stressful.
Exactly.
I mean, I'm not divorced, so I mean, that's a plus.
Yeah, there's
my kids still love
you're,
me. And
you're
call
not
me
divorced
father,
yet,
so.
You know. Yet.
Yet.
The season
always
is
something
still
to strive for.
Active. So,
your gift is crap. I'm done.
Exactly. You never know. It's such a stressful thing, right? Like you have all these expectations of what you think your gift will, you know, be received. You have this expectation that, oh, they'll love it. They'll love it. I spent tons of time and or money on it. You build it up in your mind, and then I wanted a different one. I don't want this one. Like, it's instantly destroyed.
Well, I wanted the blue one, a-hole.
Yeah, exactly. You know, like, simple things we get wrong. Because we're guys. We get things wrong. All the time. Dude. Like, all the time. So, I mean, it's a struggle this time of year for us. And everybody. But I feel especially for guys. Not so much single guys. Yes. All I gotta buy for is my cat. And my family, if I want to be polite. But, you know, especially married guys. Or guys in a brand new relationship. God forbid.
Oh, this is man, the that's gotta
worst
be, like, tough
time of year.
Right,
yeah, this is the worst time of year for that, right? Like, this brand new relationship. You just met the girl.
That says, hey, let's be in this for a long time, or is this breezy enough, like, you know, not too douchebags enough to say, hey, we're cool.
Yeah, we're a thing right now, but I'm not sure how it's going to play out. So do you get, like, you know, the dinner and say, hey, I'm going to take this out to a nice candlelight dinner and get her in, like, a little bit of cheap jewelry? Or do you go the whole 40 yards, you know, price it up, say, you know what, I feel like devoting a lot of time to this. Let's price it out. Let's do some work. You know,
I think the real struggle there is, say you're not necessarily going to be committed for like years, but you got Valentine's Day like just a few more months
right ago, around the
and
corner.
And then you can't like do something so extravagant that you can't outdo it on Valentine's Day.
Yeah,
I mean, it's the day of love, right?
It's a real struggle. You know, it really is. It's one of those you have to pace yourselves. If you just got into a relationship, right now is the worst time for you. Like, it really is.
Like, I hope she's worth it because you're about to crash miserably.
Yeah. Because if you screw up on Christmas, she's not going to forget about it by New Year's.
That sets the tone for the whole relationship.
Exactly. You're setting the tone for everything to come. Like, that is a big responsibility just to start out your relationship this time of year. The best time to start out your relationship is like St. Patrick's Day.
Absolutely. You go to park the truck together.
Yeah. Or if you're not a drinker, you just, you know, do the pinch thing, I guess. I don't know. But it just seems like it's not really an important holiday, but people go and have fun on it. You can go do karaoke or something. But Christmas,
I'm not
God forbid. Or even worse.
Not a fan of the pincher.
Whatever. Even worse, think if you started a relationship in, like, November, right? Like, the beginning of November, and you go, oh, this relationship's going really well. Why don't we do Thanksgiving?
Dude, that's a big commitment, right?
That is a huge commitment. Families. You're going to be meeting families.
And they're going to be judging you, and you really don't even know this girl completely yet. Unless
you really
it's just
don't.
Like one of those fluke things where... Oh, me and my best friend, who happens to be the opposite sex, have just decided to try and give us
And that could be even worse, because if you screw up at Thanksgiving, Christmas, and she says, you know what, I'll give them one last chance, which is Valentine's Day, and you screw that up, relationship out the window, friendship probably out the window, you just screwed the pooch for everybody.
You're definitely getting a bag of poo on your doorstep.
Sure. Her dad's going to hate you. Her mom's going to hate you even more. She's got some weird uncle in the back that's like, I know a guy. I'll take care of him. I'll get it taken care of. Like, it's a weird situation this time of year, which is why I'm glad that I'm not in those shoes.
You know, I gotta go ahead and throw it out there in case she ever listens. But my wife's awesome. So I chalk up to me not being able to get her a good gift. I was like, well, baby, you splurged so much on me. I mean, I didn't have enough money to buy you anything. I mean, it's your fault if you think about it.
You blame her for spending too much on you that she can no longer get a gift herself. Which is, I mean, like, isn't like, that you know, the I, story? I, like, the The guy sells his watch to get the girl the combs, and the girl sells her hair to get the guy the pocket watch chain, right? Like, that's like a perfect story for today, except for everybody's broke. It doesn't matter. Nobody's getting anything. We're just selling
stuff. And
then
you throw
the money.
Three kids on top of that. I mean, you're just, it's disaster.
Can we set up a second mortgage already? Like, it's...
Right?
It's truly a sight to behold.
We're gonna have to push that retirement a little further.
Did you say 80, honey? We're pushing it to 80 now. No, it's just a weird time for everybody, you know? Like, it's just the most spendy time of the year. I mean, you have to spend money on Thanksgiving. You have to... In Spain, and let's be honest, cooking for Thanksgiving is expensive. Like,
yes.
That is not cheap to go pick up a turkey, go pick up a ham if you do ham, or God forbid you do both, or something like that, you know? Like, it's just terrible. Like, it's truly
a
terrible thing.
Large family. I mean, like, you know, people say, we got big families. No, y'all don't have big families. We have a very, I mean, we're picking up like two turkeys, two hams.
Yeah.
And then all the other side fixings to go with it. I mean, it's, good God, you feed like the military.
And I mean, it's great. You know, that's America's obesity. So you gotta like multiply the food by 50, you know, to actually feed everybody.
Speaking of obesity, then that's another why this is a crappy time for me. Because of all the gosh darn food, I'm trying to lose weight here, gosh dang.
Yeah, no, it's not a fun time. Luckily, I'm sick, you know? I've been sick for the last 9 months. So my weight has kind of, like, remained the same. Outside of when I took steroids, man, you know, I got juiced. but I took medical steroids, so it's a different... You gain weight with those, which sucked, because I took those during Thanksgiving.
I can't report that.
I took steroids. No.
That crap's expensive, man.
It is expensive. It really is. But, you know, I gotta say, I'm feeling pumped. I'm feeling jacked. I'm not. I'm feeling sickly. But it's kind of a good thing because I haven't, like, had a ton of weight gain because I haven't been eating a lot. Niceness. If you want to lose weight, Josh, just get sick. That's the pro tip. Well,
I did it the other way. The other not, you know, ideal way. I'm broke. So I can't.
It's when you have ice cubes for lunch and for dinner.
And you're like, God, this is good. I'm stuffed.
I'm so stuffed. I had one piece of rice. Thank you. No, I couldn't have any more. I just couldn't.
Would you like some of this water?
No.
I could that's going overboard.
What kind of water is it? Is it tap? And how much do I owe you? Because are the ice cubes more? No, it's an expensive time of year. You know, and
do
it's
I have
just
to pay for
goes.
The cups?
It's pricey. And what sucks is, of course, like Star Wars comes out during the most expensive time of year. Like, how are you gonna make me spend $80 to go watch a movie during Christmas? Like, that's just wrong, right? Like,
it is.
And I wish I was exaggerating with the $80 claim, but I feel like I'm not. I really feel like I'm not. Like, I gotta say, going to the movies is ridiculously expensive. For no reason.
And then they got the RPX out, or the, you know, digital laser projector. Oh, everything's better. I'm not in it. Why do I have to pay... $100. I mean, jeez, they're not slapping me.
No,
I'm not smelling the what's going on in the movie.
No, it's so pricey. But that's like everything is pricey. Everything.
I mean, going back to, I said I had three kids. Originally, I had four, but I went to go see a movie and I had
and
to
had
give
to
one
sell
up.
One, you know.
So like... I mean, and the downside is, you know, I actually liked the kid. The movie wasn't that great.
Oh. I can understand that. Like, that's a big fear. I went and saw, what was it? Peach Dragon? I was on a date. She was like, hey, let's see Peach Dragon. And I was like, oh, gosh. Well, kiss this money goodbye. Because it ended up being an okay movie, but come on, son.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't worth the $900. But, you know, it's... it's just not fun, you know, selling kids and spending $1 million on movies that you don't even enjoy.
There's a lot of guilt that comes with it, you know?
Oh, for sure.
Oh, God. Like, I can't make it home. I should have totally not seen that movie and got gas. Dang it.
Yeah, and then, you know, you go, once you get home, the wife's mad because, well, you're down a kid now.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, you got to produce another one. What are you going to do? Am I right? Like, it's...
out of the business.
It's just, it's not a good situation for anybody, honestly. So
no, we thought about staying strong into that business, but good God, the cost of it. It's like, you know, I had business cards made saying, you know, if you want a baby, we make beautiful babies, but it was just too much work.
Oh yeah, it's a lot of work. She's unhappy. I mean, I don't know from personal experience, so I'm just kind of winging it here. But you know, I imagine it's a lot of work and stuff, man. Like it's probably not a lot of fun. I mean, I had a fish once, a fish tank. That sucked. I have a cat now. It's okay. It's going well. The cat part is going well. But, you know, that's about
definitely
all I can
enough,
say
right?
about it. It's going well, you know. There's nothing else to it. There's no other pros and cons. It's just, that's how you deal with a cat. You just say, oh, how's your cat? It's going well.
It's like that rotisserie cooker. You set it,
and
you
forget it. Yeah, no. Change the litter box on occasion. I've got my cat an automatic feeder, because, you know, why not?
Kids, I want to teach you about responsibility. We're gonna get you a pet. Okay, I got an automatic feeder, an automatic kitty litter cleaner.
Yeah, exactly. Life is great. What a time to be alive. But you know, I like that though. I don't have to make sure it's, you know, too alive. I don't have to check it every day to make sure it's breathing. I just kind of assume it is.
Right.
No, I mean, I spoil the crap out of my cat. Like, if you walked into my house before I moved, I left like half of its toys at the other place. When I brought it with me, I was like, half of my truck is filled up with my stuff. Half of my truck is filled up with my cats. That's kind of ridiculous. Like, that's a little ridiculous, right? Like, I probably should have drawn a line, but I didn't.
You say ridiculous, but ladies, listen, that's love right there. A lot of them go out there.
I'm not a crazy, you know, cat guy at all.
He just needs to find that special someone, that other special cat.
Yeah, for real. I need to get another cat. I don't think I could get another cat. I love my cat to death, but I'm pretty sure it's evil. Like, you know, I post, you know,
it
stuff
would kill
on
the
Twitter.
Other one.
Yeah, I post stuff on Twitter on occasion about my cat. Like, when I wake up in the morning, my cat looks at me like I'm food. Like, it really does. Like, and it's kind of weird, but at the same time, it's just...
You emitting, like, a fishy smell?
I don't think so. I think my cat just gets real pissy when I wake it up. I have noticed that it's been getting a little more aggressive when I wake it up. So
it
if
doesn't
I die,
have rabies,
you know,
does it?
I hope not, because that would be awkward. I would probably be dead in the next week or two. Maybe that's why I'm sick, dude. There we go.
Your cat is slowly
poisoning
you.
My cat is poisoning me. You know, I got my cat a little over a year ago, about a year and 4 months. I didn't get really sick until 9 months ago. The timeline is working out. This is a fantastic theory, Josh. There we go.
You had the honeymoon phase, and you did not work out. It's like the gift
that
you did not give a good
gift. It's my cat poisoning, man. Like, she does not like me. Now we know. Problem solved. I gotta get rid of the cat. No, I'll die happy with my cat. Worth it.
And your cat will be happy when you die.
Oh, for sure. You know, my cat will probably gladly eat my corpse for just for fun. Like,
I would like the taste of J Mark.
I'm not hungry, but you know, I could use a little snack. Like, it's easily scenario I could see coming true in the next 5 years. Because I imagine if me and her are still together in the next 5 years, one of us will be dead.
You know, if anyone just started tuning in right then, if me and her are still together, what the heck is this guy talking?
If you're wondering who I'm talking about this girl I'm living with. I'm killing her. That's what it is. Now, my cat, it's either going to kill me or I'm probably going to kill it pretty soon. No, I could never kill my cat. I love my cat. My cat is the greatest. As Trump says, you know, they're great. It's really great.
Great. Your pootie cat is making America great again.
My pootie cat is making America great again. You know, my cat is a great builder, comes from a great family. Just all around great person. It's gonna really do some great things. It'll definitely change some lives, and it's gonna build a wall. That's the most important thing. It's gonna
keep
be
the dogs out.
It's gonna be a real big wall. We're gonna make the dogs pay for it. And it's gonna be a great
wall.
See,
that's where you and I are parting ways, because I'm the dog guy.
You were a rabbit guy and a dog
guy. Dude, I was a rabbit guy. That rabbit became pretty strenuous with my schedule working out the way it is and how much it poops.
Well,
it was just too much to do.
It's a
and
rabbit.
A giant
Josh.
Rabbit, dude.
It wasn't
it's
like a
giant rabbit.
Yeah, no, it wasn't a normal rabbit. And then you know, you have 8 dogs and 20 kids in the mix. It's a lot of mouths to feed. You know.
I mean, I got 4 dogs. I got 3 kids, but this rabbit was like when it reached its full growth was going to be about 30 pounds. So
yeah, no, that's
it was
that's
bigger
a lot.
Than my smallest dog,
which is ridiculous.
A Schnorky.
It's no, I wasn't asking what the dog was. No. I was just saying it was ridiculous. Come on,
let's just clarify. You know, just to give the base of size.
I don't care, honestly.
I know. Love you too, buddy.
I don't do these dog things, you know. I told you not to get the last dog you got. I was on the other side of the fence. Everybody else was like, "Oh yeah, get the dog, Josh." And I said, "No."
No. But you know what? If I did not have that dog, all right, we're going into a pet story. Dogs are good protectors, though. Okay, there was a freaking raccoon, biggest raccoon I've ever seen in my backyard, dude. And if I did not have the 3 big dogs to help my biggest one fight it, it would have killed my biggest dog.
Oh yeah, like that's you know something you don't want, but still,
you know, I even got in on the action. I got a nice big stick and I cracked the raccoon
that's what I was about
in
to
the
say.
Head.
You didn't kill the raccoon, but I know you beat the crap out of it.
Yeah, it got up and pretty much gave me the finger and climbed the fence.
Yeah, no, it was.
And I mean,
it said, "Screw you, Josh." You don't
know me. You know, just to put this in perspective, I'm not really like a small guy.
No.
And I hit that thing with everything I had. I knocked it out for like 2 minutes, and it was stunned for another 5. But that sucker still got up and left.
I just imagine the raccoon coming back like a week later and be like, "You know what? I'm going to beat this dude. I'm going to beat this dude down in front of his family." Like, he was just pissed. Like, you came out of nowhere. The dogs were destroying it, right? But they, you know, that raccoon was like a messed up crackhead raccoon. Like, it did not care. It did not care.
No. That raccoon was straight thug life, man.
Like, that raccoon
it's gonna
just
come
said
back
no.
With a stick in its paw, just sitting there patting the one paw with the stick. Just being like, "Yeah, it's time for some redemption, buddy. So I'm going to get back in the house and lock the doors."
No, it's just that raccoon will come back later and be like, "You know what? This is my house now. Look at this house.
You
this
can
is my
have it. We're moving tomorrow."
No. You're moving. Nobody else is moving, Josh. The house is the new
family.
Father. The house. The raccoon is the new father, not the house.
The house. It's Monster House now. The house is your father.
The house is your father. No. That was a fun story, because you were in the party the night that it happened and you left, and then you came back the next day and was like, "Crazy story, raccoon."
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Like, I came back later that night, and Ryan was still on. He's like, man, all I heard was, I heard Alyssa come out there. I heard her, like, mumble something over the walk or the mic, and then you, I heard it hit the ground, and you were gone. I was like, yeah,
was,
man, I went out there.
It was a weird story.
Like I said, I had, it was a stout stick too, dude, and I busted that thing in half. There's blood that flew out whenever I hit it, and yeah, it's after 6 minutes or 7 minutes, it popped back up and was like, I'm getting out of here.
Which raccoons are weird creatures anyways. They're kind of douchebags and they're kind of cool at the same time.
Yeah,
but I mean, that one was straight thugging you, man. Like, he just didn't care. I don't know if you remember that video. I sent it to you guys on Facebook a while back. Of the dude whose dog's getting beat up by the raccoon, and the guy runs downstairs and throws it. Like, do you remember that video?
Throws the raccoon?
Throws the raccoon down the stairwell into just, like, this dark pit. Like, you, the camera, it's nighttime, so you can't really see down the stairs where he's throwing the raccoon. Like, he just runs outside, grabs the raccoon, and whips it, right? And I'm not, like, for animal abuse. Don't get me wrong. Like, we're nice guys. We don't want to abuse animals. I love animals.
Yeah, I don't condone it. But I will kill another animal if it's killed.
It was the funniest thing, dude. Because the raccoon's eyes were all you could see as it was drifting down into the dark pit. And it just was, like, looking back at the dude like, what in the hell just happened? Like, it was so mad. So mad. Like, it did not care.
I can only imagine what with it, because, like, I've been in my younger days, been in an inebriated state where somebody has just came and grabbed me from behind and threw me down. Like, I was just in my head, what the crap is happening? So.
Well. Speaking of inebriated states and raccoons, there was a story I read a long time on Reddit. It probably wasn't a long time ago. It was like a year ago, maybe. This guy, right, has a breathalyzer attached to his car, so he can't start the car if he's drunk. Grabs a raccoon and squeezes it to make it breathe into the breathalyzer to start the car. The raccoon passes out.
Legit?
Legit story. Raccoon passes out, right? Wakes up, man, after the dude starts driving and mauls the dude, so he has a wreck. Funniest story in the world to me. Like, can you imagine that dude finding a raccoon to use on a breathalyzer? Like, come on.
How dude, props for getting the raccoon and being able to squeeze it without getting mauled right off of it.
Well, like, the raccoon was, I imagine, had to be drunk itself. Like, that's the only way. But somehow its breathalyzer passed, right? Like, that's the only way I can see that. The raccoon had to be drunk or sedated.
Drug.
Yeah, it something.
It just smoked a joint.
Yeah, no, it just wasn't having it. It woke up after it passed out and was like, you know what? I'm about to maul somebody's face, and it's only me and you here. We're the only people here, buddy. It looks like it's going to be you.
Car's starting now, pal. Your ride's mine.
He just pushes the dude out of the car. This is my car now. Later on in life, I'm going to meet a guy named Josh. I'm going to take his house. Like, it's the same raccoon.
I'm building an empire here.
No, like, raccoons don't play, man. Those trash pandas don't want none. Unless you got buns, hun. Like, they're legitimately scary animals to me. Like, I think they're super cute, but I would never screw with a raccoon. Like, their hands freak me out.
Bless my wife. I mean, obviously, you don't want to get close to a raccoon, right?
I don't want to get close to your wife. Like,
she's going to hear that.
I know. But, she's creepy.
But God bless her. She's all sitting there. She's like, do something. Because, I mean, it was hanging on to my dog. Like, yeah. I'm sitting here thinking I'm about to watch my dog die. I was like, get me something. And she goes and brings me, like, a knife, you know, like a steak knife from the kitchen. And it's like, what do you want me to do with this? You realize I have to get up on this thing And he's already reaching out, like, swatting the other dogs.
It's like, do you not see this raccoon is 1v4ing these dogs and winning? Don't throw me in the mix. I can do nothing.
It's like, give me a stick. Give me something with range. Come on.
Build me a bow, woman. Figure it out. You played 7 days to die. We need wood.
Go get some steel and craft me an axe.
No, like, that's a little, she stood up to it. Well, sort of.
So that's, she was out there with me, but she wasn't near the action.
No, but that's still, I mean, still though, raccoons are crazy. I feel like she wins by association, because that raccoon now has her name in the book too, so be wary.
Oh yeah.
Be wary.
Like I said, whenever it got back up, I mean, it was staring at her. So I had to run back over there with the backhoe, or not the garden hoe, and like stand in front. I was like, if this thing charges at her, so I gotta go get myself back in the line of this thing.
That's luckily I do have a pistol and a shotgun and rifle. Like I like guns. So if a raccoon ever invaded my privacy, luckily I have some armament to just be like, you know what? I don't want him telling his friends that I'm, you know, a wimp. I don't want him telling his friends that I
can't be handled. I took his best shot
and
I said, screw you. Like,
I wanna drop this raccoon so that it'll be a warning, right? Put its head on a stake to other raccoons.
You know what, though? If you shoot it and it still just stares at you like...
Then you give it the gun and it has a fair chance. Like, it can make a decision. If the raccoon survives a shot to the chest, shrugs it off and goes, I want another, son. Like, then you know what? I'm going to give him a gun. We'll have a fair duel.
I'm just going to lay the gun down on the ground and say, that was my bad. I brought this out here for you, and it misfired.
I didn't mean to shoot you. It was weird, I know. But, you know, long story short, I came out here on accident. I thought I heard a possum. Are you? Did you hear a possum?
I mean, if you see that guy, tell him that was meant for
crazy.
Him. I'm done.
Speaking of possums are... I don't like them either. They freak me out. Dude. Like, there's so many creatures in this world that freak me the... hell out.
Yeah, they're the nocturnal ones.
Yes, and that's two of them. That's two of them right there. That's two of the many.
You got possums and what this... what else is there? Armadillos.
I don't mind armadillos. Yes. I think they're kind of cool, though. Like, you know, they got an armor shell. Like, they're, you know, they're pretty legit.
They hiss at you. They
get freaky, though. Outside of the fact... Oh, they do. But I don't like that they carry leprosy. How nasty is that, though? Yeah, that's like that's in my top five diseases to say no to. Like, that's just a no-no.
Stay away from me.
Yeah, no. I don't want any of your, you know, nasty leprosy. But, you know, I don't like them. I mean, I like them, but I don't like them a lot. But I mean,
I like them from afar.
Yeah, from afar, cool. But I like a lot of animals from afar, you know. Like bears, I think they're pretty cool from afar, like, or through glass maybe.
Yeah.
Put some glass between me and a bear. I'm cool with it.
You know what's freaky though? Like, if you go to the zoo and they got the grizzlies there and stuff, they come up to that glass and they crack it.
Oh, they know that you're they know that you're food. They know that you're food, man. Like,
they walk up to it like, hey, yeah, we're cool, what up? And then they get on the glass and you're like, oh, this is cool. You put your hand on where their paw is and it starts cracking, and then like, you see the ferociousness start coming. Oh god.
No, it's not cool anymore, man. It's not cool anymore, right? No, that's like lions. We cage all these animals that are much better predators than we are, without guns, of course. And they're like top tier predators, and like, we cage them and we're like, look how cute they are. They're not cute. They are just buying their time till that glass breaks. You know, one person that's a little too fat leans against it. What happens? They get out, right? Yeah, they get their food. We're just happy meals for lions and tigers and bears. Oh my.
Gross.
But I do not like chimps, man. I don't like them. Call me crazy, but I do not like chimps. They're not my style of animal. They seem a little too insane on the crazy bracket. Like gorillas, they're big. I understand they can be a little crazy. Chimps will rip your face off just for fun, though. Like, they'll straight up murder a fool and be like showing their teeth like, ha! Did you hear how I murdered Betty today? Like, Betty fed us. Betty raised us from a child. I murdered her face, though. It was awesome. Like, dude, Betty was literally your mom for the first 10 years of your life. You
she
were an
fed
orphan.
You from a bottle.
But I ripped her face off and ate it. And then
and
I
then
threw feces
I sat
at
down
her.
And rubbed myself, and then like, I snatched feces on her
like
forehead.
They know what they're doing. They're intelligent. They know what they do when they like rub feces on people and throw it. They know it's gross. Don't tell me they don't. They're somewhat smart. But it's just the way it goes. I don't like them.
Indeed.
There's a long list of animals, though, that fit that bracket. Chimps, as we said, possums, raccoons. Beagles. I don't like
Did
beagles.
You say beagles or eagles?
I don't like beagles. I like eagles. I don't like beagles. They're just one of those dog breeds I'm just not a huge fan of. They're a little weird, right? Like they are a lazier breed, but at the same time, like they're known for being like, you know, a hunting breed. Call me weird. Right. I just don't like them.
They've got a dormant aggression to them.
Yeah, like I feel like they would be the first one of many to just like call you out, right? Like if beagles were a person, I feel like they'd be a dude passed out at a house party. You walk in with your girlfriend. He's like, he cheated on you with her, and points at some random girl and goes back to sleep. Like, you're like, what the hell?
How did you know that girl?
Like, I just, you know, like, they would, if you were, you know, a beagle's friend in real life, they would walk up to you in the middle of the night and just slap you 40 times. Like, oh, there was a guy walking by outside. Sorry. I'm like, no, bro. Like,
get up.
You get that's up. That's not
they
cool.
Get your spot.
That's not cool. I don't like it. I don't agree with it. I don't have fun with this. So they also go on my list of animals that I'm not like super fond of. I just not a fan of beagles. I love canines though, for the most part. You know, not all of them.
I'm not a, like I said, I'm not a cat person per se. We've had one cat that was awesome because it was like a freaking dog, but. If I was going to get another cat, I think I want one of those Sahara cats, man.
Oh, I would love a Sahara cat, but I don't have $2,500. Those cats
nope.
are so expensive.
That's why you steal one.
No, I got that. No, for sure. But if you're going to do that, why not just steal a baby cheetah or a jaguar?
Because they...
Where's your logic there? I don't care. I would... If I died by a jaguar or a cheetah, I'd be like, oh my god, at least I'm dying by cuteness. Right? Like, my dream is accomplished.
I don't have it like Mike Tyson where I can go play with a pet tiger.
I would love that. Like, you know, when, what are those dudes' names? Like, Siegfried and Roy or whatever?
Yeah.
Right.
How often did they work with them? And they got mauled.
Yes, but think about when he was getting mauled. He was like, oh my gosh. I'm so happy and I am hurting at the same time. Like, come on, son. It's like getting mauled by a teddy bear. With really sharp claws, and you're probably gonna die from it. But I mean, still, it's so adorable. Just cuteness overload, Josh.
Yes, overload is for sure.
But
so.
No, but yeah, you know, you thought I said eagles. I do not like most birds, either. Though, I like cats. I don't like birds. I agree with cats,
well,
and they're just
like natural enemies, man.
Yeah, but I agree with cats. I don't. I'm not a huge fan of birds. Ran into a bad deal with a cockatoo once. They're douchebags. Like, I feel like their name fits them, because they're just real rude. I was almost like mauled by a bird, man. Like, and if this was a while back, right? I used to work for fireplace company, installed fireplace and stuff like that. I was working at this lady's house, and she has this big old cockatoo. Right when you walk in, there's a big cage, and it's sitting in there, and it's just screeching, right? It sounds like a devil animal screeching at the top of its lungs. And she goes, don't get too close. It'll bite your finger straight off. I'm like, okay, cool. I won't get close to it. I'm working, right? I'm semi-close to the cage. It actively reaches through the cage and grabs my shirt and tries to pull me in like a dang velociraptor. And I'm like, not today, bird. I know you're not that big and I could beat you down in a fist fight, but still. Like a freaking velociraptor trying to reach through, just screeching at me. Yeah, dude. They're freaking evil. I don't like them. Not a fan. They're on my list.
You have made the list of douchebag animals.
There are so many. Stingrays, I used to like them, but they killed Steve Irwin. Douchebag animal.
And all he wanted to do was love you. Come on.
I mean, come on. How are you going to kill the one dude actively trying to save all species and take it away from the group that should have killed him? Like, they took it away from the alligators and crocs. If anyone was going to kill Steve Irwin, it should have been the alligators and the crocs, right? Hunter. Like, yeah. Come on, his name was Crocodile Hunter. That was what he did. He should have died doing what he loved, hunting crocodiles, not a stingray. Like, I feel like that was such a cheap blow. Like, come on,
I have a feeling that's how my wife's going to die. She always says, I want to wrestle a crocodile. I think I can. Good luck with that, babe. You didn't even want to fight but you're going to go wrestle a gosh darn crocodile.
I feel like she could do it, though. Just, like, the creepy factor, though, right? Like,
absolutely. Just walk up. Man, she's a creeper.
You know, she would just creep up on a crocodile and be like, yo, crocodile, what you doing, huh? What you doing, crocodile?
She would get the crocodile would realize that she's watching it and be like oh, crap, get startled.
Bye. And then boom, it's done. Bye, I'm gone. See ya. No, like, nobody's really, like, walked up on a crocodile since the crocodile hunter died. You know, so I feel like we need that again. We need somebody to set the balance. We need someone to say, crikey, I'm gonna stick my finger in this bum. I'm gonna do it. Like, he used to just walk up.
See how long it takes for it to actually attack me.
You know, just he used to do thug life, man, on Crocs. But
thug life and Captain.
I feel like we probably are out of time, huh?
Like, probably. I think we've rambled on
for quite some time. We definitely got off our main subjects, and yeah. So we'll have to do a second episode where I guess we actually talk about movies. Because we
absolutely
never addressed
submit
that.
Comments and yeah, let us give us know. Some ideas of what you want to hear about
for real, you know,
to hear
we,
our
we probably
just,
should
just banter
touch base on, you know, what animals we hate again one day, but for now I think we'll leave it at that. We got raccoons, stingrays,
we'll dedicate a segment to it,
a lot of stuff. So until next time, this has been fun. We're gonna try to ramble less next time. We're gonna try and get better. So until then, I'm Jmart. This is Josh. We're having a great time. He's Diffuser. We probably should call you Diffuser so it doesn't get confusing.
Yeah.
We're opening up a store with our shirts on them. We need to make a shirt for the creep. That would be cool. So
dude,
go check
Minecraft
us out.
Creeper on it.
Yeah, Minecraft Creeper with your wife on it. Anywho, hope you guys have had a blast. I know I have. And I will see you guys on the other side. Peace, people.